Hello, dear ones, Father Peter John, coming to you from All Saints Orthodox Church, Bloomington, Indiana. Christ is in our midst. I want to talk to you today about a fool for Christ, again, that perhaps you have not heard of, and that would be St. Michael of Klopsk, the fool for Christ. His history is a little bit mystifying, actually. It's a good word for the fools for Christ, mystifying. He showed up at a monastery, the monastery of Klopsk, outside of Novgorod, on the feast of the Nativity of St. John the Baptist in the year 1412. Now, it's just kind of unusual because the monks arrive at church for the service and they see a monk, an unknown monk, sitting there reading the book of Acts and the books of the epistles by candlelight. And so they're, you know, going and praying in the liturgy and the service is going on and he's there reading the scriptures. Well, before the end of the service, he slips out. So the service ends and they all go to find this unknown monk. And they find one of the cells, that's a small room where the monks live. One of the cells in the monastery was locked and he was inside. And he was writing something. And so they knocked on the door and they said, please open the door. We want to know who you are. And he refused to open the door. He wouldn't talk to them. He just wouldn't even answer them. And so finally they broke the door down, right? The drama of the monasteries. There's plenty of drama in the monasteries. Anyway, so he broke the door down. They broke the door down and they get inside and they start asking him questions. Who are you? And he would say, who are you? They'd say, where are you from? He'd say, where are you from? He just repeated everything that they said to him. So they could see that they were getting nowhere. They were becoming very frustrated. But then the abbot came in, and the abbot had the spiritual gift of discernment, right? So he looked at this man, and he saw him, and he listened to him, and he realized that this man was a fool for Christ. He was somebody who was pretending to be insane because he was trying to hide his great virtue. So the abbot said, give this man a cell. Assign him to a cell, and he can stay here with us. So St. Michael lived at the monastery. Nobody knew his name. Nobody knew where he came from. They didn't know his name was Michael. But he was very obedient. He did everything that he was told to do. And some nights he would go out and sleep in the middle of a field. Some nights he would go and sleep on a dung heap. I mean, he did things to continue to let the other monks know that he was not a normal character. And so anyway, in 1419, on the Feast of the Transfiguration, a certain Prince Constantine of Moscow came to the monastery for the Feast of the Transfiguration. And after the liturgy, they're in the refectory, and the monk Michael was assigned to read the lives of the saints during the meal in the refectory. And so he was reading. Well, as he was reading, the Prince Constantine looked at him and he thought, wait a minute, I know that voice. And he got up and he started walking around the unknown monk and looking at him and listening to his voice. And he said, I know you, Michael Maximovich, the son of my cousin. And Michael's response was, he said, my name and my origins are known only to my creator. And he said, but my name is Michael. And so this Constantine then realized that his cousin, who had disappeared 7 years earlier, was here alive and well, safe at this monastery. So after that, the monk Michael continued to live in this, you know, this life of a fool for Christ at the monastery, until one day the Prince Constantine, he had a falling out with the imperial court. And so he came to the monastery and he wanted to get counsel, wise counsel from his cousin. So he asked him, he said, what should I do? This is what happened. And the monk Michael says to him, build a stone chapel in the center of the monastery. Well, Constantine didn't, that wasn't exactly what he was looking for, but he decided he was going to just do what Michael said because he trusted him. And so he built a stone chapel in the middle of the monastery. And on the day they were dedicating the chapel, word came from the imperial court of Moscow inviting Constantine to come back and be reinstated in the court. So Anyway, there are a lot of wonderful stories about this monk, Michael, about his predictions and his prophecies and his insights and his clairvoyance and all of these different things. But that just gives you a little snapshot into the life of another one of these fools for Christ who forsook the wisdom of the world in order to truly be wise in Christ. Christ is in our midst. He is and ever shall be.